Pulling grips make light work of cable installation. I'm going to show you how to install wire mesh pulling grips on ALTOS cables. As always, I have a couple tools here, and I have my safety glasses and some gloves. The trick to a proper installation is to select the right pulling grip, and that is determined by first measuring the outer diameter of the cable and then consulting with the pulling grip manufacturer for the right pulling grip. Once that is determined, the rest is easy. I'm going to wear my gloves first. Once the right pulling grip has been obtained, inspect it for damage. What you're looking for are broken wires, bulges due to excessive stress, rust, and things like that. Also give it a small tug there and smooth it. As you can see, I'm wearing leather gloves just to make sure that I don't injure my hands. Locate the cable end, and we want to make sure that all members of the cable are flush on the end, so I'm going to use a pair of cable cutters. Be very careful when using this and trim off just a small bit on the end. It's now time to install the pulling grip itself. Now, rule of thumb is the pulling grip that fits over the cable without excessive difficulty is the right pulling grip. So we'll just insert the cable on the end, and we will use a pumping action to get the pulling grip onto the cable. As you can see, with the right pulling grip, it's relatively easy. So we're going to stop about 1/4 inch from the basket, so that looks about right there. Smooth the mesh over the cable, and also give it a small tug to make sure everything is snug. And then we're going to apply electrician's tape, starting at a 0.1 inch from the end of the mesh. And we have to wrap the tape really tightly to make sure that the mesh is fully compressed against the cable. A good measure of how tight the tape is being applied is to be able to see the imprint of the wire mesh through the tape. Occasionally give the cable a pull just to make sure everything is still tight, and continue wrapping. We are now ready to connect the cable to the pulling rope or pulling tape. But between the two, we need to install a breakaway swivel, or if you prefer, a ball bearing swivel, to keep the cable from twisting during the pull. Also, once you're done with the pull, be sure to cut the cable at least 3 feet behind the pulling grip. And that's it. If you got any questions, please give us a call or send us an email at cablesystems@corning.com. And remember, Corning Cable Systems recommends getting training fiber optic installation. We offer a series of classes, of course, and we thank you.